Hello there, YouTube. This is NecroStevo, and it is time for week 3 of the Indigo League of Legends matches. This is actually my first divisional match against my long-storied rival, Trainer Connor. You guys should know his teams very, very well. I had a lot of preparation to do when battling his team just because he had so many different Pokemon that he was using. He actually predicted me to bring Bisharp as my lead and leads off with his own Samurott. I didn't know what type of Samurott that this was particularly. Samurott can run a lot of different sets. And for this particular battle, I brought a Venusaur that utilizes Sunny Day. But I didn't get a chance to use it because I switched Venusaur into a Taunt. Sunny Day has a lot of nice synergy not only with a Hidden Power Fire, also Heat Wave, and Clefable's Moonlight ability, but I didn't get to use any of it. Kind of frustrating there. He shows me the power of a Skywither. I just went straight for Giga Drain, because I didn't want to overpredict that early in the battle. I figured a Skywither was coming in, but why overpredict? And then same thing here. I figured Goodra was coming in, but why overpredict? I really wanted to see how he was going to play the Pokemon that he had, chosen for this battle. My trump cards were two things. First of all, Pinsir. I had that in the back. It can kind of sweep through his entire team. Then secondly, I had a Clefable that I brought with Moonlight. Maple, the Maple set that I brought from before with the Moonlight, Calm Mind, Moonblast, and Flamethrower. So with that, I could kind of hit everything on his team as well. Speaking of Maple, this is a good opportunity to switch it in right here. Now that I've slowed down the Goodra with a nice Thunder Wave from Sturm, this is going to be a good opportunity to just come in and set up a Calm Mind. Now he does get paralyzed here. I'm not sure what he went for. Even if he had gone for a poison type move, it would not have done that much to Maple. I just Moonblast trying to hit the Goodra. I see a Skavler coming in, and I was really curious if Connor was going to switch out to see if I had Flamethrower. Because obviously I wouldn't set up my Clefable if I didn't have something to cover some of his Pokemon. But with this Escavalier out of the way, it really paves the way for my other Pokemon to do some work. Now we see Thunderbolt here coming straight out from Raikou. I don't really care about that damage because I'm able to Moonlight it all away. And we're kind of back where we started. Since Clefable is holding the Life Orb item and it has the Magic Guard ability, I don't have to worry about that recoil damage from the Life Orb, and I still get the 30% power boost for a very easy 2-hit KO onto Raikou, whereas it struggles to 3-hit KO my Clefable. Now, with Raikou out of the way, of course, that allows my Pinsir to have a much easier time sweeping because he doesn't have anything to resist my flying type attacks anymore. For some reason, Connor brings in Conkeldurr right here. I really think he meant to bring in Samurott. Conkeldurr would have been pretty useful to have later on in the battle, but that may have been a misclick or something. He actually does bring in Samurott here and taunts me to stop me from Moonlighting to get the HP back. And he surfs, but with plus one special defense and my max HP investment, even at less than a half HP, he's not able to take me out. And I almost finish off his Samurott with a single Moonblast. He is finally able to take down Maple here, but it's kind of a little bit too little too late. Just because at this point in the battle, I have a lot of momentum on my side of the field, and I think he was missing three Pokemon just from Maple, and that kind of leaves an easy cleanup job for Mega Pinsir to go through. Now, Mega Pinsir is going to have to go for Quick Attack and return on Spiritomb, hopefully to be able to take it out without getting burned or anything like that. And then outside of that, he still has his Goodra left that I paralyzed earlier in the battle. So I don't want to leave Mega Pinsir in against Goodra because there are Ice Beams to be found in these Alps, as it were apt to say. That's not apt to say at all, that's fine. But I do want to use this as an opportunity to kind of pivot from Zapdos. He gets paralyzed a few turns here. I brought in Zapdos as a sacrifice here so I could get a free switch into my Mamoswine. I could have just gone directly into Mamoswine, but I was very, very afraid of getting frozen. I don't take any chances in more competitive type battles. So once Sturm, it kind of served its purpose. I wanted it to go out in a nice little blaze of glory. I got a little bit of chip damage on a Goodra here, but that's okay. Zapdos is going to go down. I get to go out in a Mamoswine and drop an Icicle Crash on Goodra's dome. Very, very easy damage there as long as I hit the attack. Goodra's not taking that from that level of HP. So, Icicle Crash is going to be able to easily clean out Gudra, which means he's down to just Samurott, and Samurott does not have that much HP left, and that means an Ice Shard is going to be enough to finish off Samurott as well. So, that was a good battle. Thank you very much for the battle, Connor. That was my first divisional match, so now I am 3-0 in the league. I think that still keeps me tied with Brady at the top of the Weast there. But I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll talk to you all later. Bye-bye now.